Hello viewers, welcome to Bulls vs. Bears Trading Academy. On this channel, we provide the supply and demand areas of Nifty and we validate them in the next trading session. If you are new to our channel, subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon to get the updates. You can join our Telegram group and WhatsApp group using these links provided in the description box. So now we'll see how Nifty performed with respect to our levels. So the resistance zones given are 11453 to 11467. So these are the resistance given zones given on 16th October. So those are 11453 to 467, 453 to 467. Another zone is 11500 to 11570, 11500 to 11570. So now today we'll see these two zones with respect to Nifty movement. So where did we open today? Our first opening candle was this one. So this long shadow candle is our first opening candle. See here time, you can see the time over here, 9:15. So this is the time level and this is the price level. So this is the time, 17th October at 9:15. So we opened on this candle. As soon as we opened, we went down. Again, we recovered in the first 5 minutes itself. So it gives us clues that there is some buying over here. Why this buying? Because it went down. When it went down, people started buying it and pulled it up till this level. Hence this shadow. Why did this shadow form? Because of all the buying pressure. Because of all the buyers only, this candle formed a shadow downside. And when it went up, some sellers were active here and sold it till here, and the candle closed it at the opening itself. Excuse. So the next candle opened here and it went up. After going up, there were some sellers who sold it from here, hence this shadow. Oh, we need to understand why shadows forms. So actually when this is our candle, in the intraday it forms like we go up. When we are going up, the close of the candle also follows it, but if there is any selling and we come down, then the area where price traded becomes a shadow. So this shadow indicates sellers at the top, and at the bottom it indicates the buyers. We need to understand what is trend and what is consolidation. Trend is simply high, another high, another high. I mean high, low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low is a trend. Consolidation means within this range, within the high and low. See here, this is the, suppose we consider this candle. So within the high and low, another candle is trading over here. See here, this red candle is trading within this candle range, within the high and low of the previous candle. This candle is trading within the high and low of the previous candle. So we call this as consolidation. We do not call it as a trend. So if at all, if you are into any position, I mean if you have taken any position, how should the price move? Price should move in a trend. So the basic definition for a trend is, for an uptrend is low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low. If this candle consolidates with respect to the previous candles, then it is called as a consolidation. I mean, if it moves in the high and low of the previous candle, then it is called as a consolidation. See, the high and low is this. So the high and low here, it is here. This green candle is consolidating with respect to this one. Overall, it is in an uptrend, but it is consolidating. So you must be careful at such areas. Now we'll see the validation. So here it formed a spike of selling. It came down slowly to take support on our level. While it was coming down, there was some buying over here. It was coming down, but with some buying. It came down, there was a buying, good buying on the lower level of our zone. So it went up. Once it has closed above this, so here it formed an intraday resistance over here also. See this one? Here the top. Why did this top form? Because there were sellers at that area, hence that top formed. So now we'll place a horizontal line over here. This candle closed above the zone, but it was very near to the resistance level. Why? Because why did we draw this line? Because on the spike here, there were sellers. Because of such movement, price came down. Here there were buyers. You can see at the bottom, there was a spike over here. There is a spike. It indicates a buyer. So it went up. And though it has closed above this, we are very near to the resistance level. If it had shown momentum, we could have taken a trade. So it went consolidating. See, all these candles are consolidating with respect to this candle, moving inside the high and low of this candle. So they were consolidating. They touched this resistance line and came down. While they came down, here you can see the buying started over here. I told you how buying comes, because the basic formation of a candle is, it started here, it went down actually. When it went down, buyers entered the market and moved the close higher. Hence this spike over there, hence this down tail. This tail formed only because the buyers bought this and moved it up. So the next candles also consolidated. And when it closed above this and started sustaining, see, every candle you can see some buyers in this, buyers and sellers, but it was taking support over the zone. It was taking support over these candles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 5, 35 minutes. See, for half an hour, it took support over this zone. So we can take a trade. We can initiate a trade over here with the stop loss of this candle or at the bottom of the zone. So it might be around 15 to 25 points. So if you have initiated a position here with a stop of 15 point. See the target at the end of the zone, till the higher end of the zone. If you have carried this, that's it. For half an hour, it took support over here and it went up. So how did it go up? In a trend, in an uptrend. Basic formation is low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low. So it was, market was giving clue. It is forming a trend. Higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low. Compare all these lows, higher lows. So this, we can see a downtrend also here. High, lower high. Lower high with respect to this candle, it is low. Lower high, lower high, lower high, lower high. Here it started consolidating all these candles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All these six candles, these candles consolidated with these are in consolidation with respect to this candle. See, all these were playing in the range of this candle. Once it has broken the range and closed above this and started sustaining, we could have initiated trade either here or anywhere else after some good move. So this is how we need to look at price action. After it had touched this, there was some selling over here, but it managed to close above this. And today's closing was 11600. If you look at a 15 minute time frame, easiest way, so one of the easiest way to trade is, we must wait for a 15 minute closing above the zone. Within the zone, we should not be trading. These So supply zone means from anywhere within the zone supply can occur. So demand zone means anywhere from within the zone we can see some buying. So once it has, see this 15 minute candle, after it has closed above this zone, after it has closed above the zone, we could have initiated a trade over here. This is a simple technique. We can use a 15 minute candle or a 5 minute candle. See, in this 15 minute candle, we can, this is not, this is like a spinning top with a shadow at the top and the and a shadow at the bottom. So no closing was good, no candle was giving a good closing above the zone, but this candle with a good momentum, it closed above this. We could have risked a small amount, 10 to 15 points, to gain this one. So over here, after this move, all people were saying Nifty will go some 12,000, 13,000, 50,000. But I was speaking of this down move from very on that day itself. On 24th September, I gave the indication of down move while always speaking of the up move. This is completely based on the Elliott wave, Neo van, different techniques, and through different chart trading techniques, I predict all this. So on the YouTube also, many people were claiming of Nifty touching 13,000, 15,000. But I was sure of this down move. The way it came also, I was expecting Nifty to go up from this level, but it went into some more correction. This is like a WXYXZ kind of formation. After this, now we are going up. So how is this move up now? So here it all started, this up move, and now we'll see some good rally in Nifty also after some correction. So this is how Nifty reacted with respect to our levels. Regarding tomorrow's zones, I'll be posting them in the WhatsApp and Telegram groups. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.